Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the official ARC podcast number 163. My name is Mistletoad, and I'm here with the core team. Your host for tonight, as always, the one and only Atlas. The floor is yours, sir.
Thank you for the introduction, Mistletoad. And folks, welcome back to another edition of the ARC Daily Podcast, number 163, April 12th, hump day. And Wednesdays, we have Kelly Snook here with us. So if you have some questions, we're going to give you a chance here live to speak with her and ask away. Great day of growth. Total vault accounts, friends, is at 4,360 and growing. Sheesh. Liquidity on PancakeSwap, always, always on the positive, on the growth. 879,552 BUSD. IOC reserves, boy, it's been wild today. Went a bit lower, big buys coming in. 463,165 BUSD, folks. Nice and steady. The system is so balanced. Amazing. Spark price pool, 544.29 ARC. In case you're wondering, that's a street value of $3,113.34. Live here on the podcast today, we're going to find 115th winner. Maybe it's somebody here that's live on the podcast. Maybe it's someone on the other side of the world. Just 5 days ago, we had a young man from India who worked his way to be able to get his first direct level of referral through the foundation. He got his 250 BUSD of bond invested. And folks, he won the Spark Prize. He's even made a video how this is changing not only his life, but that of his family. And these folks struggle to feed their kids. It's not a joke. It's a serious. And we intended for everyone to have an opportunity that the Spark would be life-changing. Depends where you live. Depends what your financial situation might be. But I think it is wonderful to see someone really having a positive impact and a change through being an investor here. With that, I'm going to turn it over to Brett Nordine. Hope you're doing well, sir.
Hey, you doing good. Yeah, busy day on the ARC. Great to see the growth. We were cranking it out today. I know Alex is probably tired and going to bed now. We spent a lot of time going through the landing page, last minute details, getting that buttoned up. We've also got another video we're going to create, kind of a sizzle video. And we've been working back and forth with one of the video creators. And so that's been taking a little time today. So getting ready for the PWA launch. And we have confirmation that it looks like Friday evening EU time, so that'll be European time, so it'll be after the podcast probably, maybe around this time. If we can pull it up a little, we will, but we will release the PWA to the public. So we'll make an announcement on Friday to confirm that, and we'll have a final walkthrough video and the instructions and the download link and all that kind of stuff available for everyone. So that'll be a great day. Looking forward to that on Friday. We'll have a press release going out. I may hold the press release to Saturday just to make sure that we don't mix something up. If something happens, we delay a day or two. That won't be out in the wild. And people trying to go to the download link for the PWA and it not being available yet. So I may hold that a day and then get that out. We're also going to do a Medium article to make the announcement for the PWA launch to the public. And yeah, that'll be great. And we'll be able to share those things. And I don't know if Brad's on yet, but we'll probably need to put those into the sweep widget for people to clap up and share the link where they can. So yeah, that's the big news of the day, I would say, from my end.
Fantastic news. And we wish there were more hours in the day, right, my friend, to do all we have to do here.
Yeah, you know? we have a lot of marketing stuff, just sort of all happening at once, and a lot of, you know, similar resources sharing and getting done what we can get done quickly and in, you know, the high quality fashion and confidence to release things, you know, in a timely manner. So yeah, all these things, they're coming. Everything's going to be, you know, now that we have the PWA out, the landing page is getting buttoned up. The Zoom presentation is out there. We just need to formalize the process for, you know, the onboarding and everything, but that can all come together pretty quickly. So the major components are sort of sitting there and waiting for certain dominoes to fall. And PWA is the first in that group. And I know we've got the Fiat on ramp and that kind of stuff happening. So it'll come together really quickly. I think everybody's going to be pretty impressed and satisfied with what we've all been waiting for.
Sonic boom time is coming. Hope you guys are ready. We're really expecting to generate quite a lot of heat. And I think our philosophy here, you guys have noticed a bunch of them, but one of them is really building, doing the work. Build quietly and let the products make the noise. And we do believe there's going to be quite some noise that's going to be happening here, not just in the DeFi space, but also in the real world, folks, as the mobile application comes out and followed by the utilities and so much that we've been working on for so much time. So for us, it's an opportunity to share and bring value to every single one of these great investors that are here with us. Earning, growing every single day. So, you know, we're creating these tools. It's for your use. Just, I think it was like 3 days ago, I was looking through YouTube at the amount of content that's happening for ArcFi. You know, understanding of there's a certain way to grow organically that takes its time. You know, the All Aboard session has been nothing short of a great success, really focusing our efforts as a community to promote, support, uplift the content creators here. Folks that have never, you know, made a YouTube video in their life, stepping out of the comfort zone and doing something for themselves, for the project. Crypto Putter, great example. He's here with us today. Hope you're doing well, my friend. You know, going out there making videos just because he was so excited. I mean, he had no intention. Hey, someone's going to join my syndicate. You know, he's just had his moment of understanding and building his confidence as to what's here for all of us and sharing that and understanding that perhaps in the future, someone might find that video as a great educational piece to see his journey, what he's doing on the arc. Why is he so excited about it? There's so many different perspectives, so many different personal stories of why folks are in DeFi, why they're here on the arc. And we all share a common denominator, which we are investors. We're looking for opportunity. We're looking for growth. We have been rugged from here to eternity by you know, so many teams or just bad contracts or opportunities. And we're all searching for that constant, sustainable opportunity with a team and a community that is here for the long term. With that, let's open it up to some questions. We have Kelly Snook here. Hope you're doing well, my friend. Calm, cool, and collected on the arc. Family is all right.
Whoops, did I lose you?
Oh, no, we're here.
Oh, okay, great. Weird. Whenever I unmute myself, my AirPods freak out. So I lost the end of your sentence. I just heard calm, cool, and collected, and then it went silent. But hello, it's nice to be here.
How are you doing?
I am doing okay. I'm at home for 3 days preparing to go give a talk at a big music conference in L.A., and then I go right back to Nebraska to keep taking care of my dad. It's a big week, a big day today. He's moving over into assisted living from rehab, so that's great. He's doing better. But all the hard work has been paying off, and yeah, it's going okay.
And this talk that you're going to give at the music conference, this is into the music production. I know you're a musician. Is it something to do with that?
It's a panel on wearable technology, so wearable musical instruments.
Ooh.
Which is my field, technology development.
That sounds really awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is there like an example of something?
I'm one of the creators of the Mimu gloves. So these gloves, they've been around for about, I don't know, 12 years now. They are gloves that allow you to like custom map your gesture to music. So you can control, it's like sci-fi controlling music with your hands and your arms.
I've seen something like that. Not live in person, but on YouTube.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And there's some, I think, like with a laser or like a harp, like, I mean,
I understand. There's that.
Oh, awesome. That's quite fantastic. Well, we wish you a great trip, and let's see if folks here in our community, they have a question for Kelly. As you know, she's created this fantastic calculator here to project. And I know the every time the Crypto Badgers do a video review of ARC every Sunday, they always praise your calculator. It's like, it's, I don't know what the term is exactly they use, but it's like scarily accurate or something like that, they say. I'm probably misquoting them. It's very, very accurate. And of course, your sister, Rebecca, did the one for the app, which is quite fantastic. So yeah, go ahead, folks. Here she is. Ask him questions if you like.
Yeah, Miss Kelly.
Hello.
Hello, this is Rafael. I got Carlos from France. And I think he has a question. I'm going to translate for him. Carlos, unmute yourself and ask. Carlos, quítale el mute y haz la pregunta y ya te va a contestar. Ya fue la que hizo la calculadora. Habla en español, yo te traduzco.
Pero el tema de la calculadora es referente a lo que se dice de la estación.
Sí, haz la pregunta, dime qué pregunta tienes para ella. Ella está en vivo, ella es la que desarrolló la calculadora de la plataforma. Estás en vivo.
Pues la pregunta sería, conforme uno va ingresando, pues uno mantiene el BN positivo. Entonces, los días suma el 2% o el 2%
okay.
Se mantiene con la inversión.
Okay, his question is about the NDV, and as he brings new capital, he wants to know if he calculates the NDV and if it stands the 2% more days, if he can see that on the calculator.
Yes, on my calculator, yes. On Rebecca's calculator, I'm not sure. I think so as well, but... I know that on my calculator, I calculate the NDV, and there's a column over to the right. You just have to scroll over to the right. When you add new capital in, it should add it in correctly. If it doesn't, and if it seems wrong, definitely let me know, because I'm still debugging features, especially the features that I don't really use. So the way to see it is if you go to the Wallets tab, for example, or any of the templates.
Give me 1 second because it's too much to translate.
Ah. Carlos, sorry.
Carlos, ella dice que cuando tú estás en la calculadora tú la puedes mover para el lado izquierdo y tiene más información para tu lado derecho en el margen. Y ahí puedes ver el día que se extiende y puedes ver también cómo cambia el NDV.
Es que eso, digo que eso es lo que lo confunde a uno, porque cuando en la parte superior de la calculadora, como ella dice, al lado derecho,
pues sí, pero lo puedes mover como si fuera a hacer un swap, la página, la información, la puedes mover para la derecha y tiene más cosas para tu lado derecho. ¿Se entiende? Mm. La puedes mover.
Rafael, Cato, ¿están hablando de la calculadora del Excel o la calculadora de la página web, de la DApp?
De la plataforma, la del app. No, la del Excel. Perdón, la que está en la plataforma. The one.
Okay, están hablando de esta, okay. All right, I just confirmed, Kelly, he's talking about the Rebecca calculator on the D app.
Yeah, I can understand Spanish, but I can't speak it. Oh, great. Oh, well done. Well done for busting out the Spanish, Natalis. I'm so impressed. Okay, well, we can try and answer the question together then, whoever's driving here. I don't know. I'm sure it will calculate the NDV and change the ROI at the appropriate point, but I don't know how you add it in on a specific day. I don't know if that's possible to do on her calculator. Her calculator is meant to be a bit simpler than mine, so that might be a bit past the threshold of simplicity. What do you think, Atlas or Brett?
Yeah, maybe he should use the Excel.
The Excel,
yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
If he wants to go full DGen mode, as they say.
I feel like that particular question is definitely something to be handled with the spreadsheet calculator, yeah. Because then he can plan it out, you know, certain extra added deposits
Brandon,
in the future.
Use your Spanish, please. He does Spanish. I know he does.
Okay, remember, this is a multi-language podcast.
Carlos, ella tiene una calculadora en un Excel. En un Excel yo te la voy a enviar y en esa vas a poder entonces mirar y proyectar esa fecha que tú quieres en esa calculadora y no en la que esté en la app, ¿entiendes?
Ah, vale, sin problema. Sí, porque es que con la de la A me pierdo un poco, porque en la A, la plataforma, la calculadora, no te saca los 96 días. En la parte de arriba, en la plataforma, en la parte derecha, te dice los días, el margen y todo eso. Pero cuando tú vas a la parte de abajo, a mirar día tras día, pues ya se hace el conteo de los días que sale al 2%, no hay 96 días.
Sí, es una proyección, pero yo te voy a enviar el Excel y así lo vas a poder. Me parece que Leiner también le pasó y con el Excel tiene
vale,
la respuesta.
Problema, lo miro.
Sí. Bueno, Carlos, saluda. Mira, ahí está Miss Kelly, ahí está Atlas, que es uno de los founders. Aquí está todo el grupo de ART. Atlas. He's on friends, and he lives, he's from Colombia, but he's working on friends, and he lives in Spain. And he got through the school, he contacted me, and he invested on ARC.
Congratulations. Okay. Felicitaciones, bienvenido.
Gracias. Atlas, do you want to just show him where he can see the NDV on mine? If you go to the wallets tab, scroll over to the right just to show where the ND, where you can see the NDV.
Can you remember Spanish?
Yeah, I can't speak it. Sorry.
Happy days.
Yeah, it looks like it's column Z there. Column Z.
Yep.
La estás viendo, ¿verdad?
Claro,
Maybe somebody can actually test that and just see if it's actually working, but I hope it's working.
No, it's working. I can see it.
Okay.
Yeah, I can see it, but I'm going to send it to him. Because I
okay,
have
great.
It. Yeah, I'll send it to him and explain it to him, you know. Yeah. Carlos,
okay.
Yo me la mando y yo me la estudio.
Sí, sí. Entonces, bórrate el presiona el micrófono para no molestarlo para que la otra persona entre. Gracias, Carlos. Thank you, Miss Kelly. I appreciate you.
You're very welcome. You remember to make a copy for him. Don't try and just have it use this one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know. Okay,
thanks for the question and for the question in Spanish.
the international group. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Language is not a barrier for us here, as we are a global solution and protocol. Inflation's everywhere. Mm-hmm. In all languages and all cultures and all countries, they're facing the same heinous debacle of inflation, rearing its ugly head. Who would like to be next to ask Ms. Kelly any questions? Maybe SK Crypto. I know he always loves to geek out on the calculators.
Aww, it's so nice to see you here, SK.
Hey, appreciate that, guys. With the new schedule, it's harder. I'm in the middle of my work day, so just kind of listening. Yeah. In, but I'm doing well, y'all. Yeah. Hope you're good.
Cool. Nice to see you.
Hey, if I was around, I'd buy you a coffee. Get you pumped up. Laser focused. Glad to see you here, brother. Thank you so much. Anyone else? Oh, we've got Kuzo in the house. Great to see you. We had a great conversation today on the VC. Kuzo, do you have any questions? Have you played yet and forecasted with Dr. Kelly Snow calculator for ARC? We have two of them, actually. One from her here, the Excel, and then the other one from Rebecca Snook, her sister, which is this one here on the PWA. Have you had a chance yet?
Oh, hey, Atlas, Kelly. Yeah, we had a great conversation. I actually played around with the one on DAP earlier, okay. Just a little bit. You know, still getting the hang of it. I am new, but thought join you guys here, learn some other things about the project. But yeah, don't have any questions, but it's an amazing work that you guys have done, some big brain power behind this project. So yeah.
Well, there you go. Kelly brings the big brains. SK was another one who I mean, these guys were here.
Really, in the clay. Love big brains and projects. That's what we need more of it. So Kelly, thank you.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for the great compliments, brother. Yeah, absolutely amazing. The advisors, the team, everyone that had a hand in molding this clay that is ARC. Very hard now. And even though we're sailing on the ocean, we are holding strong and growing. And we say it every day, we need a bigger, much bigger boat as we go on this journey and picking up so many folks all across the globe. So yeah, this you'll find this calculator, Kuzo, if you go to the app or on the homepage. You can go to the more menu here on the screen and you can hit calculator. This one will show you her sister Rebecca's. That's the one I think you've mentioned you've been on before. But let me let that load just so you see it. Well, I can do that. Nope, that's not the right one. Here's a calculator, the one I think you've play with. But in the company site, if you go to the white paper, there is a link. When you come here, best practices.
Ah, that's where it is. Sometimes I have trouble finding my own calculator.
It's also up here. But wait, okay. Is this one here? There we go.
Okay.
Now we know where it is. You could get out for it a little bit. But yeah, this is the really, really big daddy, powerful, scary accurate, you know, which is great when you have a dynamic price that's pretty steady and stable.
Yeah.
So before we let Kelly go, is there any person that would like to ask her a question?
I have a question for you, Atlas.
Yes, go ahead.
Can you make it so that I win the Spark Prize today? I haven't won it yet. And I really, really need it.
If I had a penny or a Satoshi for every time somebody requests that, boy, my DMs, I still have, I think, over 1,400 messages I haven't gotten to.
I do have one question. Hey, Kelly. Same question as Kelly's, actually, about the Spark. I'm just kidding. Kelly, I was probably confusing myself earlier today, and I asked this, Coach Brad answered, but I was trying to understand at the when you reach max payout, so paid out of 80,000 ARC.
Yeah.
What the difference between like a 1 CWR or a 1.5 CWR would make to the end total withdrawn ARC. So here's what I was confusing myself with. If you compound at, let's say, 60% goes into compound, the whole lifespan of that wallet, then wouldn't 40% of the total have been withdrawn? Am I making any sense? Or like, as opposed to doing a 50-50 split, then you've withdrawn 50% of the tokens, which seems
Yeah, you're confusing yourself a little. You could play with a calculator. That might actually help to just stare at the calculator for a couple of hours. But yeah, all that it does, if you have a higher CWR, is it just means at the end when you're maxing out and you're doing only claiming, you're going to end up claiming more. So as a percentage, and the whole thing will just go faster. So it's the same number, total number of tokens that you get out of the wallet. I mean, not counting differences in small differences in gas or whatever that you paid on different schedules and that sort of thing. But like, just in general, like in principle, and you can see this in the best way to see it is to look at the calculator tab of what he's got up there right now, because you can look at the different CWRs and just see that it's the same total at the top, except for the 0.75, because that's not actually optimized. But if you end up optimizing, well, I call it tuning, the even the 0.75 CWR, you get the same number of tokens out if the wallet is optimized. So assuming you're optimizing all the wallets, it doesn't matter what CWR it is, you'll get the same total number of tokens.
I see. Thank you. So the higher CWR essentially puts a longer phase of claim only in the lifespan of your wallet.
At the end. Yeah, at the end.
Okay. Yeah. That's the piece I was saying. Thank you.
Yeah. Sure. And obviously the exception to that is if you're getting additional tokens into your wallet from other sources, like rewards or airdrops, then, you know, that will also change. But assuming there's no rewards coming in and stuff like that, then the CWRs won't change the total number of tokens.
Right. Okay. That makes sense. Thank you.
Sure.
Let's have a quick question if you could answer, or anybody can actually help.
I'm just wondering, ahead.
When I do my daily claim of 50-50 or 60-40, instead of claiming that 40 to my wallet, can that go into a direct airdrop to a new wallet? Is there a way to, through the airdrop tool?
Not directly, not automatically. You would have to take those airdrops and do it through the airdrop tool.
Mm-hmm. So, okay. So once it goes into my wallet, or whatever it is there, then I can.
If you want to use the airdrop, you would have to allocate to the airdrop. You will not be able to. Go ahead, Kelly.
I was just going to say also, you can't airdrop to a wallet that doesn't already have deposits in it. So you'd at least have to have another wallet started.
Yeah, no, this one has like about 150, and I'm just trying to turbocharge it a little bit. I'm trying to figure out a way to turbocharge that with using my other wallet.
Yep. Your other option is to, like you said, let it build up into your wallet, the ARC, and then transfer to the other wallet.
And just transfer, okay.
Yes. I would say in terms of turbocharging, if what you mean by turbocharging is increasing your NDV so you can stay at the 2% daily ROI longer, airdrops will not increase your NDV.
Well, that was the next question I had. But no, I'm just trying to get that wallet up to, you know, a higher balance faster, I guess. And I was thinking of using the other wallet to get there.
You can do that.
Not that it makes, you know, I guess dollar wise, it's all the same at the end of the day.
It's, yeah.
I'm thinking from one bucket and putting it in another, but
Well, yeah, and by doing that, like let's say you allocate 10 or 20% of your daily to the airdrops bucket, then that's taxed when it's withdrawn to the airdrop bucket, and then when you send it from the airdrop bucket to your other wallet, it's taxed again. So it's not, so you're really just, you know,
you're moving
money around, but you're not, but you're actually taking a hit on taxes.
Yeah, I see that. Got it. Guess I'll just have to break out some more cash then, huh?
Great question. And as we say here, folks, always, there's no such thing as a dumb question when it comes to ARC. It's a complex system, especially if you're new. And that's why we're here every single day with the community to answer all the questions you may have. Thank you for pitching in, Brandon and Kelly. Is there anyone else? Last chance, last caller, you're up. I think we need to get Suze Orman on the ARC. Have her do, you know, maybe a weekend, you know, have her come in here. And what's your NDV at? Well, airdropping, multiple wallet strategy. Yes, I think you, yeah. What's your credit at right now? That would be so fun to have her over here getting folks organized on board the ARC. Well, always something to look forward to, folks. Thank you, Kelly, for being here and taking the questions. Thank you for all the hard work you and Rebecca have done to make this project so successful.
My pleasure. Thanks for having us.
All right. All right. Let's get this crypto, folks.
Let's get this crypto, baby.
Oh, God damn.
Oh, yeah. Let's get this crypto.
Looks like it's all aboard time.
I think we lost Atlas. You there, Atlas?
Yes. Sorry, I didn't realize my mic was muted. It happens sometimes automatically. I have a request. Give me a second. I'm trying to find a message. Oh, wow, this is really cool. All right. I was asked to read this message by Mr. Vladimir Anunnaki. And we talk about the Anunnaki here sometimes. Coach Brad's a bit of an expert on the Anunnaki, but he asked if I could read this for him. And, of course, we'll be happy to do that. So let's wait a little bit, Mistletoad, for the all aboard. ARC is like an ark of salvation that makes normal people to a better world. The trump card of the project is precisely the fact of guiding people to be coherent and balanced, because even the best and most sincere person tends to make mistakes. Like the Anunnaki, who gave us the power of knowledge by imposing the rules of humanity, on humanity, this has nothing to do with religion. This is humanity, which has its own rules. The ARC system embraces these rules to lead us towards a better world. It is logical that today this is possible only through DeFi, decentralized finance, the finance of people, of humanity. All right. Thank you so much, Vladimir. Let's go. Sheesh. Beautiful. Very, very beautiful. And it is a pleasure to have you here, my friend. Is he still here? I know he was here earlier. Got so many people I have to scroll through. Mistletoe, do you see?
I do see him. Yeah, he is here. That was a beautiful message.
Thank you. Fantastic, sir. Pleasure to be able to read that for you. All right. Mr. Mistletoad, what do you have cooking for us on the Olive Board?
Yeah, today we actually have Amanda, aka AJ Metz, here in the house. She's going to show us her. Yeah, round of applause. Big round of applause for her. She is one of the newest content creators here on the Arc and has been absolutely killing it. I think it's a nice kind of change in pace. We have a lot of videos and content creators here that like to go into more of the analytical side, the numbers, dig deep into the statistics of the vault and everything like that. But Amanda does a really good job at, you know, pulling at the heartstrings and making wholesome videos. So I think it's a nice change up, and it's definitely, it encourages everyone to get out there and make content on Arc. So I definitely want to give her the spotlight and show her new video.
Thank you.
Are you able to share your screen, or do you want me to do it for you?
If you could do it for me, because I did it last time. It was a little clumsy, and I know you guys are, you know, kind of pros at that. So if you wouldn't mind.
I'm gonna give it a shot here. I know Alice might have to take over, but one sec here.
No sound. No, sir.
Man, I don't know what's going on. Okay, I sent you the video if you can share it there.
Of course, I'll be happy to. Cheers. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Amanda, your content's becoming really one of my favorites. I enjoy sending that to my friends from the real world that are, you know, working. They have their kids. They're busy. You know, they know I'm a crypto. They know I love crypto. A lot of them are crypto investors, and they hodl. And, you know, they're the same people that I tell them, hey, it's time to sell. You've made a ton of money buying the Floki or this or that. And they never do, because they just fall in love and they think they're going to become a billionaire. Hey, Atlas, I'm going to become a billionaire. I even got my dad and we're buying. I'm like, brother, it's time to take profits, pay yourselves. And, hey, it's hard to bring people into crypto and expose them to such gains and not have them just completely just go gaga, you know, crazy star in their eyes, and see them later not hearing wise advice, which is always pay yourselves. And that's a great thing about ARK, that we don't have to sit there and go blue in the face trying to convince them time and time again, please be responsible, be smart, pay yourselves. So I'm going to pull up the video here for us. So I really like your content, because they could really, really understand and relate to it. A lot of our investors here are experts. You know, they're folks that have been in crypto for a while. They know their way around. Most of them have learned through trials and tribulations and losses, which is part of investing, that they've learned to diversify. They've known to find great opportunities, and they tend to be very advanced on the technical side, on managing and reading white papers that most people in the real world, I don't think that they have that bandwidth. If I'm honest with you, that's why we here try to simplify ARK and try not to drive them too crazy with looking under the hood at all, how everything works. Because a lot of folks don't have a lot of attention span. All right, let's go ahead and share this window. Mr. Toad, let me know. Is it showing for you?
It is.
Yep, we can.
Okay. And Amanda, you can raise your hand or just say, hey, and I'll stop it if you want us to. So great to have you here. Thank you for another amazing video. I'm sure it's fantastic. I haven't had the pleasure to see it yet. So let's all enjoy it.
Cool. Thanks.
Hi, Amanda here. Today's video, I just wanted to take a few moments to talk to you about what the ARK community is like. I don't know about you, but when I first started on my ARK journey, I was doing it on my own. I didn't interact at all with that community because I felt that it was an established group of people who have known each other for a while, who have been on this journey together. And I was an outsider. I'm someone who doesn't have any prior experience with investing in crypto or DeFi. Heck, I don't even have any experience investing, period. A 401k is, it's, you're not investing, that somebody else is choosing what to invest your money in, honestly. So this was a completely new experience. And there was some hesitation on my part to engage with the other members, but my father, who got me involved in this whole journey, gave me some advice and suggested that I try to make a video about what my experiences have been like. And well, you saw that. You saw what the result of that was. It was my first video. And it was my first video ever. I make plenty of videos, but of my children, you know, on my phone, you know, for family memories. I'm always the one behind the lens, not in front of it. So it was a little intimidating making the video. And then to add to that, the idea of submitting that video to that art community was really terrifying. You know, how are they going to respond to it? Are they going to just sort of be like, oh, that's cute, and, you know, give me that little pat on the head? Are they going to scoff at it? Because I am not one of those people that are putting a lot of spreadsheets and facts and figures into my videos. I'm just talking to you guys like I'm sitting here having coffee with a friend. Is that something that they will understand? And I submitted it. I figured out I would take the jump. And here's what happened. I immediately heard back from that community. And I was asked to be a featured guest on their podcast. I mean, that's incredible. Not only did they like the video, but they accepted me without any questions asked. So here I am, you know, this first time investor, this first time video maker, being asked to speak about that on their podcast. And I did. I did it that next night. Was my slot, and my stomach was flipping, and my hands were shaking a little bit, and I was so nervous that I would say the wrong thing, that I would use the wrong word, that I would just sound stupid. But the outcome was very different. So they played my video and I introduced it. And what happened was I all of a sudden gained like an ARC family. They all, every single one of them, rallied around me. They lifted me up. They praised the videos. They gave me tips on, you know, how I can do things different or how I can keep it the same, what they liked about the video itself. They were encouraging and accepted me, no questions asked. So it was a really incredible, positive experience. And it made me feel a little bit more comfortable that if I had any questions, I can ask them. I mean, I can always ask my dad, but you know, my dad's one person, and this is an entire community of knowledge that I can tap into. And now I was comfortable enough to do that. So I had a question last night, actually, for them. And I reached out to the group. And again, a little bit of trepidation, like, are they going to just say, hey, Google it, you know, you can find it on this page? Or will they actually take the time of day to really have that personal conversation with me and help me with what I needed help with? And I will tell you, there was an instant response. And then there was a second instant response, and then a third instant response, and a fourth response. And all of a sudden, that entire community were coming together and answering any question that I had and giving me tips on how I can explain this to other people in a way that I felt comfortable. And again, they were all rallying around me. You know, I guess it's not just a tagline for them. It's not just a catchphrase. They genuinely want the people that are going through this ARC experience to be happy and confident and feel comfortable with their journey. Because if I'm comfortable and I'm happy, I'm going to recommend this to somebody else, and they're going to recommend it to somebody else. And that ARC community grows. So here I am. I am here to tell you they are wonderful. They are not judgmental. They are accepting. They are an incredible source of knowledge that they drop anything just to respond to you, and they embrace you and want you to be a part of this journey with them. So I'm here to tell you today that, ladies and gentlemen, if there is any hesitation and you're feeling like you might not fit in with this group or they might not be your group of people, I can assure you that they don't view it that way. If you're on the ARC journey, then you're part of the ARC family, and that's it. So do it. Get involved. Reach out to the team. They're there to answer any questions you may have, to help you with any issues, to encourage you, to lift you up. I can speak firsthand to that. So it's been a really incredible experience so far. I really hope that you guys start to get excited about it and become part of the journey as well. And until next time, bye.
Group hug, group hug, group hug. Great video.
I hope you guys all got the warm fuzzies from it.
Oh, we did. Absolutely. And we love your confidence and you know how transparent and real you are with what you're putting out there, because we've said from day one that our project is for the masses. It's for the average Joes and Janes, the Uber drivers, you know, the truck drivers. We have Raphael. He, you know, is moving fuel from pipelines and, you know, very risky job. He's got a young boy. There's so many people that are not in crypto and DeFi. And we have an amazing community, and we wanted to start with the experts, you know, the Dr. Kelly Snooks, you know, the T-Drips, the Donatellos, the Florida Realtors, folks that understand crypto, so that as they go on their journey and they're the first set of investors on board, they would be able to educate the masses that are coming. You know, we call them the pillars of the ARC. The foundation, T-Drip, and all these amazing people, Brandon, and you know, we cannot accept and be able to educate all these folks if we didn't have an army in place who understands ARC like the back of their hand, who can give advice, who are empathetic. You know, just because we're free, just because we're in a position of abundance and being able to the best we can for our families and for our financial futures, doesn't mean that we don't have an immense responsibility with the folks that are stuck in the job they hate, in conditions in third world countries or even in amazing America. People are living paycheck to paycheck. They're getting payday loans to be able to make ends meet. And there is a better way. So it is our responsibility to free them and to empower them. So you're exactly one of those great folks that we need to be very empathetic with and take the time to educate and answer all those questions and empower you so that you could do what you want to do with your financial forecasting and your future for your family. Coach, did you want to say something, sir?
I just thought that was an amazing video, and it did give me the warm, fuzzy feeling that you said. right when I watched it, I DM'd you. I was like, oh, please, can you come on the podcast and show that? Because it is the content we kind of need. We do a lot of the analytical stuff, and, you know, it's a change of pace, and I love to see kind of the personal experience videos, and we do need more of that. So anyone that out there that has a YouTube channel, I do challenge you to kind of make video styles like that. Or even like take advantage of the YouTube shorts. And all you have to do is, you know, put your phone on, go for a walk or something, take a 60-second video about talking about ARK. So it's super easy. And yeah, thank you. Thank you again.
Thank you. It's been, like I said, it's been a great ride, and you know, coming to this group, and you know, like I said, you know, in the video, of course, I've got my dad that can explain things to me, and you know, and I trust what he says. But to have that entire community to, you know, assist, like it did the other night when I kept bumping up against a wall trying to introduce a couple of people to the concept of ARK. You guys were there, and it wasn't in a way that I felt spoken down to in any way. It just from day one was like, hey, you're here. That's cool. What do you need help with? And I think that is something I can't speak to the crypto world and whether or not that's rare, but I just think in general, everybody's kind of so wrapped up in doing what they need to do that they don't always take the time to see the other people around them. You know, and they just get frustrated and they might be a little bit short of temper, and you know, they're an expert on it and they expect everybody else to be expert also. So I just, that's not the impression that you give off. And, you know, I'd mentioned the idea of this last video when I was talking to my father, because of course, like I said, ARK is obsessive, and it seems like that is all we ever talk about anymore. And I had this idea about the people involved with it. And then that very next night, I believe it was you, Alice, started talking about, you know, people wondering what kind of group you were and can they trust you and you know, can they rely on you guys and what do you guys are like? I called my dad back and I said, that's what I wanted to do the video about. That's so crazy. He just said it the very next night. So it's kind of been like a little bit of kismet too, I guess. So I've just, thank you guys. And I'm excited about it.
Yeah. We love to have you on.
Absolutely. And,
hey guys,
and
can I ask a question? I'm sorry if I'm going against the protocol here. I am new, but that was an amazing video I saw from AJ Metz. But the question I have is the 2% that's getting calculated daily, does that based on your net deposit value, or that's on a principal balance that's bound to increase based on how much you compound?
It's based on your NDV. So everyone starts at 2%. And so the NDV is basically the net deposit value. It's how much you put into the system. Once that NDV goes below zero, then you fall down to the 1%. But we like to say that that's kind of winning, right? Because you essentially have got your ROI and you're dropping down to the 1%.
No, okay.
I understood the question differently. I think he's talking about that you earn 2% daily of what number? And so the answer to that question then is you earn 2% of your principal balance, which, as you said, does increase over time because you're compounding part of your daily rewards, right? So if you have like 100, regardless of what your NDV is, your daily rewards is going to be calculated against your principal balance.
Hence, it makes more sense to compound it at the higher ratio. So the higher your principal balance is, the more tokens you get awarded daily. Do I have that right?
Yes, you're going to grow your principal balance more quickly if you're compounding at a higher rate. So you will experience a faster growth of your principal balance. If you mess around with the calculator, though, I think you'll find that at the end of the day, when you reach your max payout cap and you actually withdraw that last those last tokens on your final day, the net tokens that you gain in the system, it comes out pretty close to the same, regardless of your you know, your CWR. But mess around with the calculator, the calculator that's built into the DApp, and you can do exactly that experiment. See your net result with a CWR of 1 or 1.5 or 2 or whatever.
Yes, no, I totally understand what you're saying, that the end result is the cap of the 80,000. What I was saying is that based on the initial investment, the rate of growth to get to that 80,000 can be achieved with a smaller investment if you are compounding at the higher rate. And that's why it was important for me to ask that. The 2% is applied to from your principal balance and not the NDV. So I think I got that.
Yep. Yeah, you can get faster growth if you're compounding at a higher rate, correct?
Thank you, guys.
All right. Great question. And folks, in the interest of time, as we're trying to get our podcast to be a limit of 1 hour before we go to the Q&A, but you're all welcome to at any point interrupt and ask your questions. Just to let you know, after we finish, we do a Q&A session as well. That's not on the recording. So you're also able to ask your questions then. So we went ahead and we ran the Spark Rewards for tonight. And the winner of the Spark Rewards, their wallet ends in 8AF6. They won 566.04 ARC. And they are a first-time winner. Congratulations. You are officially in nitro mode, my friends. Oof. Anybody here live on the podcast? Is this your wallet? Please do let us know. We'll give you a very special shout-out. All right. What was that?
I said I was waiting for it to get a little bit higher first before I want to win.
Why not? Why not? It's doing quite great. So I'm going to turn it over to you, Mistletoe, as we are in the interest of time, and we have a meeting that we have to run to after the podcast. So we'll probably do a short Q&A for today. And whenever you are ready, if you want to set it up and let the great folks know how they can win BUSD, what the all aboard session is really all about. All aboard!
Hello, everyone. This is the wheel of the toad, as Brad likes to call it. But yeah, this is our daily sweep widget. Right after the podcast, I will post another link. All you'll have to do every day, look up for that new sweep widget link. It takes about 5 minutes out of your day. You're going to go in there, like, comment, subscribe on all the videos. It's just a task list of all the things you have to do. There should be a Twitter you have to retweet. I know we want to get as much traction on Brandon's tweet there to YouTube to try to get his channel back. And yeah, after you do all those things, you'll be entered into this wheel to win $50 to $100 worth of BUSD.
And how long does it take to qualify, to do this every day?
I mean, there's some guys that can do it in 2 minutes. So it's 2 to 5 minutes. It doesn't take long. It's honestly
easy. Like, easy money.
Yeah, it's pretty much just like brushing your teeth. Just while you're brushing your teeth, you know, like a couple videos, subscribe. And you can get into it. It's easy.
How many folks do we have participating for today's contest?
We got 62 today.
All right. Well, we can do so much better. I mean, there's so many opportunities here to win every single day on the all aboard. So on the count of three, Mistletoe, let's make it happen. 3, 2, 1.
Another winner. Congratulations, Raphael. You won $50 worth of BUSD. Well done, sir.
All right. Thank you for everyone that participated and didn't win tonight the All Aboard contest. You have another opportunity tomorrow and every single day. It takes a couple of minutes of your time. You support the content creators here on the ARC. This is what organic growth is about. We prefer to give you these prizes to the folks that are invested here, that are passionate about ARC. You do not have to go out and write a Medium article or make a YouTube video to really help organically grow the ARC. and push those algorithms. You can just participate, taking a couple of minutes while you're having your coffee in the morning, or maybe at night before you're going to go to bed, and check out some of his content. It is absolutely amazing. Amanda is doing great work. The Fleming, the Crypto Badgers. I mean, Donatello, a video day about ARK, and we're seeing so many folks come and join us. King of FOMO, and then there was a gentleman here today, Ohio. Is he still here? You see him around Mistletoe? I think Ohio was in a little bit earlier.
Oh, nice. I didn't see him.
I saw him. Yeah. I didn't want to interrupt. We're talking, so didn't want to call him out there. But when we see him again, we'll thank him for his fantastic video. I love what he's doing, sharing his journey. Definitely smart money. A couple of max wallets here at ARK. Shout out to Ohio. And in the interest of keeping it short, we're going to skip the DeFi sessions for today. We'll do more DeFi sessions tomorrow, as we do have a meeting to get to, folks. We will end the podcast. We'll do a small Q&A session here to answer more questions. And want to thank everyone that came to the podcast today and participated on this wonderful hump day. Shout out also to Dr. Kelly Snook for being here, taking questions from our investors, as well as thank you, Amanda, for being the guest on the All Aboard sessions here. Everyone that participated in the All Aboard. And of course, we can't leave out the Spark winner for tonight. That's in Nitro mode. Hope you enjoy the massive exponential growth that is the Nitro mode here, that NDV just you know, crashing through the gauge all the way up, my friends. We'll be back tomorrow, same time, 4 p.m. EST, 8 p.m. UTC. For the folks that are listening, thank you also for participating. If you're listening at a later time, we hope you found it educational as well as entertaining. Take care of yourselves.